Is it possible to get 160 horsepower in 30 pounds without using pistons? According to Astron Aerospace, its functional prototype can, and it promises to extend the life of combustion engines, which at this point have just been given some relief since they won't be banned in Europe after all. In fact, it's very difficult to prohibit combustion cars since in our neighborhoods there's no electrical network capable of supporting so many car chargers. This Omega 1 engine doesn't have pistons, it's a rotary type, and it doesn't have apex seals like Wankel's. Let's see in detail how it works. The machine consists of two axes synchronized by gears. On these two axes, there are a total of four donuts. These donuts have grooves. Let's say we have two male donuts and two female donuts. At the bottom, the male donut passes through the intake duct and begins to generate vacuum. The air enters behind it and fills up. Going all the way around, now start to compress the air. At the same time, it's performing the reload of the next compression. The air is compressed to 14 bar or 200 psi. At the same time, on the side, there's a duct. The air passes through the duct and enters the pre-chamber where the high-pressure fuel injector is located. Fuel is added as it enters. At this point, we're in the middle of the engine. To enter the other donut, there's a rotary valve that allows or doesn't allow the passage. This valve is just a disc with a hole. When it's the right time, the fuel-air mixture passes through the hole of the rotary valve and enters the male donut on the other side, which it advances, sucks in the mixture that is at 14 bar. At quarter travel from the donut, the rotary valve closes and we come to the spark plug, where the lightning strikes and ignites the mixture. We now have 270 degrees of expansion, where the male donut tooth finally goes through the exhaust hole. The cycle then repeats itself. Now, is this engine two or four stroke? Well, in the first rotor, the intake occurs. At the end of the full revolution, the compression stage now begins, which takes another revolution. As we see, the intake and exhaust occur at the same time, typical of a two-stroke engine. But let's continue to see what happens. At the end of the turn, the air passes to the pre-chamber where it's bathed in fuel. The rotary valve opens and the mixture enters the combustion donut. The mixture passes the spark plug and ignites. The expansion stage begins, which lasts for 270 degrees of rotation, and then the cycle restarts. As you can see, the exhaust stroke at the other side of the tooth is also taking place, obtaining the other two remaining strokes, the combustion and the exhaust. The engine has the four strokes but produces two and two simultaneously, so it can be classified as a two-stroke. Now, what are the characteristics of this engine? Is it really better than a four-stroke with alternative pistons that go up and down? According to the manufacturer, Astron Aerospace, their engine is capable of achieving performance values close to 60%, which I really wish was true, but until it's fully proven, I deeply doubt that statement. A piston engine barely passes 40%, therefore obtaining twice the performance without considering other physical principles that prevent it seems to be complete madness. 2. In a Wankel rotary engine, there's a spatula called an apex that seals against the casing to prevent gases from passing through, similar to a piston ring. The Omega engine has nothing. If nothing, how do you prevent gases from passing? It just uses very, very fine tolerances to prevent gases from leaking out. The separation between rotors and the stator is only 0.1 millimeters or 0.004 inches. For example, muscle car superchargers use this system. They have very low gas leakage, but we're talking about devices that work at a maximum of 400 degrees Fahrenheit. The Omega 1 is not a compressor, but an engine. The combustion motor will be working at temperatures above 1100 Fahrenheit. So, with a minimal expansion wrongly calculated, it would cause the rotors to touch, and in the event that this happens, it would end up with the engine blocked. The only possibility is to make the donuts out of titanium, which has much less expansion than aluminum or steel. The production value when using titanium and very fine tolerances could raise the manufacturing value too much. Titanium is widely used in aircraft, which is why the engine is being developed by a company dedicated to aerospace. In addition, it must also be taken into account that low-tolerance seals only work well at high revs. Point 3. Number of parts. As a first measure, we don't have the valve springs that are heavy to press and subtract a lot of power, which is a very good thing for the Omega 1. We don't have camshafts either, although we do have the upper shaft where the two female rotors rest. We also have a rotor that only performs intake and compression, and another rotor where expansion and exhaust occurs, in addition to the intermediate rotary valve. Basically, a number of parts wear something similar. Theoretically, since we don't have seals, we don't have friction either, which would be most important compared to a piston engine. In addition, the use of titanium and the hollow part in the center of the rotors makes the engine lightweight. Having a supposed thermal efficiency of 60%, it does not require big radiators, reducing weight and increasing reliability. Point 4. By having rotors turning to one side and another pair turning to the other, the gyroscope effect cancels out and also produces very little vibration. Due to its low weight, it's a very interesting engine to be used in motorcycles and also in airplanes. In addition to any other type of manual machine such as lawnmowers or a range extender in hybrid vehicles. Point 5. It idles at only 1,000 RPM and can top out at 25,000 RPM. The large rev range makes it very flexible. Probably when idling at very low revolutions, the fuel consumption is very low. At higher RPM, seal clearance improves and power increases. Point 6. This engine not only works on a computer, there's a unit that can be seen in operation in this video. Although apparently it's one of the first units or is still being perfected, since you can see a nice oil leak around here. However, leaking oil is a clear seal problem, so changing it for a better one would solve it. Also, the important thing is that it doesn't burn oil like Wankel's. According to the manufacturer, the oil lasts 3 times longer than in a normal piston engine. Another detail to take into account is that it uses 2 spark plugs as in the Wankel engine. This is because the combustion chamber is very long, and in this way it's possible to ignite the mixture faster. The 2 spark plugs also help to obtain an aeronautical certification in the future, since they give redundancy. Also remember that the rotors do not touch and that the synchronization is done by gears. I guess it'll be a matter of time until we see the engine running or simply abandoned. Personally, I did not find tests on a dynamometer, nor did I find anything that certifies the 160 horsepower and 30 pounds that it supposedly has. In addition to the short video, that's its only proof in operation. Do you think this engine can go far? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to leave your like or super thanks and share the video with your friends so that they find out about this artifact. My name is Francis and hope to see you in the next video. Bye!